Back to the RENSON'sYard yard. In this episode, we're working on this new to us JCB 190T, and what we have to do is replace the cylinder here for the attachment quick disconnect, as the way we received it, the cylinder has a pretty good bend in it. To do so, we have to remove the two bolts here, and same thing on the other side, and then we'll be able to free up this plate, and then we'll be able to remove the pins at each end and get the cylinder replaced. Okay, same thing on the other side. I will have to disconnect the wiring here. It seems that the cylinder needs to be at the halfway point in order for us to access the pins, because if you retract it all the way, they still come in from the plate here on the inside. So it's better to bring it halfway and line it up. It is possible that one side comes in completely before the other one starts to move. In that case, you just stop it and move the cylinder left or right by hand. So now I'll actually disconnect the cylinder and get myself some pliers to take out these cotter pins. Okay. Like that, easy enough. And there we go. That's one. And that's two. And now the cylinder's completely freed. I'm sure you can see here really how much it's bent. And you can also see that here on the side, there's a big gap between the seal and the actual face of the cylinder, so that's quite problematic, because mud, ice, or anything else could easily get in there and then completely scratch up the cylinder. I'll have to check with our parts supplier if we're only getting the cylinder itself replaced, or if the end pieces here come with. If they don't, I'll just unscrew them from either side. Anyways, I'll catch up with you guys in a few days when we get the new part. See you then. I'm back, and this is the new cylinder, which does include the end pieces after all. So it's going to be a pretty quick install. One.
Perfect. All done. As usual, I hope you guys enjoyed, and thank you for watching.